I don't think anyone ever expects to wake up one morning and find themselves caught in the middle of a war between two secret organizations. I know I didn't. But here I am. On one side are the Templars, better known these days as Abstergo Industries. They're in the business of control. Politics, economics, technology. They won't stop until every single one of us serves them. Literally. Fighting against them are the Assassins, a group dedicated to safeguarding humanity's free will. I was born into the Brotherhood. A couple of weeks ago, the Templars found me. They took me prisoner, strapped me into a machine they'd built, and put me to work. It's called an Animus, and it's where I spent most of my time. My name is Desmond Miles, and this is my story.
You okay?
I told you he'd be fine.
Bastards!
Now, I just saved your life.
Saved my life? You kidnapped me! You strapped me into that thing!
Animus. It's an Animus.
I don't even know you people! Why are you doing this to me?
You have information we need, Mr. Miles.
Information? I'm a bartender, for Christ's sakes! What do you want me to do, teach you how to mix a martini?
We know who you are, what you are.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Don't play coy with me. There isn't time. You're an assassin. And whether you realize it or not, you've got something that my employers want. Locked away in that head of yours.
But I'm not an assassin. Not anymore.
Yes, your file indicated as much. Something about an escape. Most fortunate for us.
What do you want from me?
For you to do as you're told. The Animus will allow us to locate what we need. Once we have it, you'll be free to go.
I am not going back in there.
Then we'll induce a coma and continue our work. When we're done, you'll be left to die. Truth be told, the only reason you're still conscious is because this approach saves us time.
You're insane.
So what is it, Mr. Miles? Live or die? Lie down. A wise decision.
Whoa. Where am I?
You're inside the Animus.
Which is...
It's a projector that renders genetic memories in three dimensions.
Genetic memory.
Seems you'll need a bit of a tutorial. Very well. We'll start simple. What is a memory, Mr. Miles?
It's the recollection of a past event.
Specific to the individual remembering the event.
Yeah, sure.
What if I told you that the human body not only housed an individual's memory, but the memories of his ancestors as well? Genetic memory, if you will. I discovered something most fascinating. Our DNA functions as an archive. It contains not only genetic instructions passed down from previous generations, but memories as well. The memories of our ancestors.
And the Animus lets you decode and read these DNA files.
Precisely. I've spent the past 30 years trying to understand why. I discovered something most fascinating. Our DNA functions as an archive. It contains not only genetic instructions passed down from previous generations, but memories as well. The memories of our ancestors.
And the Animus lets you decode and read these DNA files.
Precisely.
But there's a problem. This is the specific memory we're trying to access. Unfortunately, when we try and open the memory, your mind withdraws. You lack the confidence to step into your ancestor's body. That's what happened earlier. You got knocked out of the target memory and pushed back to a more stable state.
Why?
It's your subconscious. It's resisting. We've found similar reactions among patients who undergo hypnosis to relive traumatic events. They can't jump directly into the specific memory. They need to be eased in. Even then, there can be problems.
So how do we fix it?
We find a memory you can synchronize with, and we move forward from there. You'll get used to it. This is the closest we can get, so it's where we'll have to start. I'm uploading the tutorial program now.
he's experiencing a far better adoption rate than the other subjects.
I want that progress report by tomorrow morning.
I've got some work I need to do. So you've got the rest of the night to yourself.
I think there's a problem with the Animus.
Nope. It's working fine.
I'm pretty sure it just ejected me
I'm pretty sure you should shut up.
You ready to finally tell me what's going on?
We have to stop them, Desmond. When they access that last memory of yours, they're just getting started. They want to change everything. The way we live, the way we think, the way we are. You've gotten the lecture from Vidic about what's wrong with the world, how we need order and discipline, so they're going to give it to us. Only we don't have a say in the matter.
How?
The Templar treasure. They think it...
Miss Stillman?
I'm here.
I need you to upload Desmond's files to the database.
Got it.
So what? You're using me to find this Templar treasure? What do they call it? The Peace of Eden?
Yes.
Well, it's looking like it's at Messiah, so I don't know why they're wasting all this time with me. Why don't they just send their people to pick it up?
They can't. It's not that simple. The artifact from Masayef, they had it. It was destroyed in the accident.
Then what are they hoping for me? You know, for my ancestor, to tell them?
They're hoping he'll show them where the other ones are.
You mean there's more than one of these things?
Oh, Desmond, you have no idea.
Is there a problem, Miss
No, Warren. Everything's Denver on my end.
Then where are the files?
I've got to move these files before he gets suspicious. We'll talk more later.
Get up, goddammit! Listen!
Oh no.
Seems your assassin friends found us.
What?
How'd you do it, Desmond?
Hey, look, I don't know what you're talking about, but whatever's going on down there has got nothing to do with me.
They're here for you, and I sure as shit didn't invite them. What's the situation down there?
We're taking heavy fire.
Can you contain it? Or do I need to evacuate the prisoner?
Only five or six. We've got them outnumbered. Couple of wounded, but we'll pull through. We'll get it under control.
God damn you, Desmond. You couldn't leave well enough alone.
I told you I had nothing to do with this. How would I even contact them? Telepathy? Come on.
Doesn't matter. They'll be dead soon enough. Here, have a listen.
That's been neutralized.
Looks like the cavalry won't be coming.
Dunno, Doc. We're freaking out a minute ago. Your little research facility not as secure as you thought it was? Worried they'll be back with more?
I don't think so, Desmond.
What Lucy here is trying to say is that there aren't any assassins left to come for you. We've been very busy this past year, hunting down your little enclaves, your desert communes and whatnot. I'm afraid you're on your own.
I'm sorry, Desmond.
You mentioned the desert. Do you think...
They sent a team there, but the place was deserted. I don't know where your parents are, and I can't promise they're still alive. But I think they got away.
Thanks. Thanks for checking.
It's not as bad as it seems.
What are you talking about? They just killed, literally killed, my only chance of getting out of here. And then I find out the assassins are all but destroyed, and Christ, I still don't know what these people are planning. But I do know they plan to kill me when they're done. I am screwed, okay? What do you want me to do?
Just try and have a little faith.
You're...
Have faith. Rest up, Desmond. You're gonna need the energy.
Even earlier than usual, Doc.
I'd like to get this over with as quickly as possible.
If you say so.
Don't be so glum, Mr. Miles. Today is a historic day. One that will be remembered for years to come. Remembered by some of us, anyway.
Impossible. The student does not defeat the teacher. So it seems. You have won, then. Go and claim your prize.
You held fire in your hand, old man. It should have been destroyed.
Destroy the only thing capable of ending the Crusades and creating true peace? Never.
Then I will.
We'll see about that.
My heart to know wisdom, and to know madness and folly. I perceive that this also was a chasing after wind, for in much wisdom is much grief. And he that increaseth knowledge increaseth sorrow.
Destroy it! Destroy it as you said you would!
I can't.
Yes, you can, Altair. You both.
We've got it.
What the hell was that?
Well?
We've got the map.
How many?
At least half a dozen.
We don't need them all.
We should assume some amount of decay. I can't imagine they'll all still be functioning. At least two appear to reside on landmasses that no longer exist.
We'll dispatch teams to each site and determine viability. We only need one, after all.
What about the rest?
Collect them. Let's not leave anything to chance. Last thing we need is some damn survivor making trouble for us in the new world.
And the assassin?
We have what we need. Kill him.
Wait. You know how these things work. I doubt we'll be able to walk right in.
What's your point?
We might need him. His memories. I'd recommend we hold him until we have confirmation that there aren't any surprises waiting for us at the sites.
This is a waste of time.
You said it yourself. We shouldn't leave anything to chance.
Very well. Ensure we have no further need of him, then kill him.
Fine. Stop undermining my authority!
I just saved your ass.
Let's go. We've got a lot of work to do. Don't get too comfortable, Mr. Miles. We'll be back for you soon enough.
What the hell is that? Were they keeping here before me? And what happened to him? What does it mean, I wonder?
We have to go.
Lucy, where have you been? Why did they...
Now! Get in.
What's with the blood? Are you okay?
Look, we have maybe 10 minutes, maybe, before they figure out what I've done. If we're not out of here and on the road before then...
Wait, we're leaving?
Desmond! I promise I'll answer all of your questions. Later. But right now, I need you to just shut up and do what I say. So please, get in the Animus.
All right.
Listen to him. A fine set of lungs.
What shall we call him, my lord?
Ezio. Ezio Auditore da Firenze.
Get up. Let's go.
Yeah, well, I'm gonna need a second.
There isn't time, Desmond. We have to leave.
Hey! You're not supposed to be up here! Open this door!
I'm calling it in.
We have a breach in the research wing. I repeat, there's been a breach in the research wing.
Nice walls. Questing... Fancy.
There they are! Don't let them get away! Holy shit! Look at this place.
What about the cameras?
I rigged them to loop old footage. How do you think I managed to hide all your nighttime snooping from Abstergo?
You're good.
So I've been told. But they're on to us now. We need to hurry. Fuck. I thought this card would work. It must be on a separate system, and I don't have the code.
Wait. Shit. Come on.
How did you do that?
I don't know.
Let's go. It's always something.
What was that in the Animus? Subject 16? Ezio, Audi, Audi something?
I think we've been wrong all along. That's why we need to get out of here. Vidic and the Templars, they're only part of the problem.
What do you mean?
I'll explain when we get there.
Get where?
Get in.
You're joking.
It's for your own protection.
Oh, man.
We're almost there.
Thanks for that. It was great. Shoving the trunk, bouncing around. Loved
this
it.
Way.
So, gonna tell me what's going on now?
There was a reason for the escape, Desmond.
Figures.
We need your help.
For what? Another treasure hunt through time?
Abstergo's gonna replace their Apple of Eden. The map your ancestor found guarantees it. The other assassins, they'll do what they can, where they can, but...
What? What is it?
We're losing this war, Desmond. The Templars are too powerful. And every day, more of us die.
I still don't see how I fit into things.
We're going to train you. Turn you into one of us.
What? No. No, you've seen me in action. I'm no good at this, and even if I was, it would take months. Years, even.
No. Not with the Animus. Not with the bleeding effect.
But I'm just one guy.
Sometimes, that's all you need.
So that's why you found him. My ancestor. What was his name? Ezio?
If you can follow in his footsteps, you'll learn everything he did, just like he did. Look, there's more to it than that, but it'll have to wait. Trust me, okay?
All right, I'm in. Tell me what you need.
Really? You're sure?
I thought you'd be happy about this.
Sorry, I'm just a little surprised. I spent the whole ride over here figuring out how I was gonna convince you to do this.
Save it. After what those Templar bastards put me through, I'm ready, willing, and able.
Thank you. Lucy! You made it! God, it's been so long. 7 years, can you believe it?
Indeed. Welcome back. Ah, so this must be the infamous Subject 17. Desmond Miles, was it?
Who are you?
I'm sorry, where are my manners? I'm Sean Hastings. This is Rebecca Crane.
Nice to meet you, Desmond.
Right, well, it's been lovely chatting, but if you don't mind, Desmond, it's best we get straight to work. Time is precious. Doubly so these days.
We've got everything set up and ready, Lucy. Just say the word and we'll get going.
Here, I brought you something. A parting gift from Abstergo.
Whoa! The memory core! This is amazing! With their data, things are gonna go a lot faster. I'll get to work on merging the code.
Hey, listen. I just wanted to say thank you. And that I'm sorry.
Sorry?
Yeah, you know, before. Everything at Abstergo. It was just... I wasn't ready.
It's okay.
No. Going through all that. Knowing that the Templars still exist, what they're planning.
What's done is done, Desmond. You're here now, and that's what matters.
Lucy, I've been seeing things. Symbols in my bedroom. The code on the keypad. Just like Altair.
It's from the bleeding effect. You're taking on more than your ancestors' memories. You're taking on their skills, too. In this case, Eagle Vision.
Skills?
You're more receptive now. So if all goes well, everything Ezio learns in the Animus, you'll learn too.
You really think this will work? That I'll become an assassin?
You already are an assassin. You'll just be better at it.
Yeah, hopefully much better at it. I mean, seriously, I saw the tapes from Abstergo. You didn't even try and escape.
What a dick. So how does this work? Of course.
Deep breath.
Ah! Oh, what are you, a tiny child?
Sean!
Well...
here we go.
You and your collaborators are hereby sentenced to death. Cover! I'll kill you for what you've done!
Hello, this is... They call me Subject 16. Listen, I don't have much time. There's something I have to show you. We have been lied to this whole time. Everything we know, everything we've been brought up to believe, it's wrong.
Everything all right?
Better than all right. You're making amazing progress.
Amazing's quite a strong word.
Then why are we stopping?
Prolonged exposure to the Animus can have, side effects.
Awesome.
It's nothing to worry about. You haven't shown any of the symptoms.
Symptoms? What symptoms?
Degradation of cognition, temporal hallucinations, multiple awareness issues, overlapping realities, you know.
So what you're saying is...
What we're saying, Desmond, is if you're not careful, you may not need the Animus to visit with your ancestors. Which wouldn't be a bad thing, assuming you could control it. Up until now, though, no one has.
Subject 16.
We have safeguards, Desmond. And they kept him in the Animus for way too long, sometimes days at a time. We're being careful with you.
I hope so.
Anyway, I was hoping we could test out your skill retention. See if you've picked up some of Ezio's abilities.
I'm game.
Great. Meet me downstairs when you're ready.
What could 16 have found that needs so much secrecy and security?
Well, I don't know, do I? Lucy thinks it's something about the Codex, but I'm not so sure. I'm all ears if it's as life-changing as 16 says. Blimey, if I was allowed to use the Animus, I'd be the one in there finding out. Instead, as usual, I'm forced to sit here on the sidelines.
So what's the plan?
We're gonna see what you've managed to retain. Come on! Abstergo's out there, looking for us. They're better funded and better equipped, so it's only a matter of time before they find this place. We need to be ready for them when they do. I want you to activate the warehouse's defense system. I'll let you figure out how to reach the sensors.
Oh, come on! Not even a hint?
Open your eyes, Desmond.
All right, you gotta tell me. Why Ezio? Why Italy? I mean, we could have just gone back to Altair again. Followed him during his early years.
It started with 16.
Ah, good old Subject 16. He repainted my room, you know. With his blood.
A few of the records of his later Animus sessions are missing. And the sessions that are there... After everything the Templars put him through... After everything... I put him through... It's all scrambled. If we hadn't pushed 16 so hard, we'd have the answers already. And maybe he'd still be alive. All right, I think we're done for the day. You should get some rest.
Lucy, what happened to 16 wasn't your fault. You were just as much a prisoner as I was.
Thanks. Good night, Desmond.
What is this? Where am I? It's Acre. Wait a second. Why aren't I following Alta here? I'm stuck here with Maria? Oh, shit. That must be... This is one weird dream.
Sorry to barge in on you like this, but it's getting late and we were... Hey, you okay?
Yeah, all good. Weird dreams, that's all.
All right. I'll let you get ready. See you in a few.
Ah, good of you to join us.
Sorry. Long night.
What a professional. What a professional approach.
Leave him alone.
Well, you'll forgive me if I want to get some actual work done. Madness, isn't it?
Sean! Please, that's enough.
All right.
Hey.
Hi.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Everything's fine.
You sure?
We lost two more teams last night. That's eight more of us just... gone.
I'm sorry.
I don't know what to do anymore. It just keeps getting worse and worse.
Hey, remember what you told me? You gotta have faith. And look, here we are, safe and sound.
For how long? And when they find us, then what?
When that happens, if that happens, we'll deal with it. I'll keep you safe.
Anyway, enough with my little breakdown. I should get back to work. And so should you.
Greetings, Prophet. It is good you have come. Let us see it, to give thanks. We must speak.
Who are you?
Many names. When I died, it was Minerva. Before that, Merva and Mera, and on and on. The others, too. Juno, who was before called Uni. Jupiter, who was before called Tinia.
You are... gods.
No, not gods. We simply came before. Even when we walked the world, your kind struggled to understand our existence. We were more advanced in time. Your minds were not yet ready. Still not. Maybe never. No matter. You may not comprehend us, but you will comprehend our warning. You must.
None of what you are saying makes sense.
Our words are not meant for you.
What are you talking about? There's no one else here.
Enough. I do not wish to speak with you, but through you. You are the prophet. You've played your part. You anchor him, but please be silent, that we may commune. Listen. When we were still flesh and our home still whole, your kind betrayed us. We who made you. We who gave you life. We were strong, but you were many, and both of us craved war. So busy were we with earthly concerns, we failed to notice the heavens. And by the time we did, the world burned until naught remained but ash. It should have ended then and there. But we built you in our own image. We built you to survive. And so we did. Few were our numbers. Your kind and mine. It took sacrifice, strength, compassion. But we rebuilt. And as life returned to the world, we endeavored to ensure this tragedy would not be repeated. But now, we are dying, and time will work against us. Truth turned into myth and legend. What we built, misunderstood. Let my words preserve the message and make a record of our loss. But let my words also bring hope. You must find the other temples, built by those who knew to turn away from war. They worked to protect us. To save us from the fire. If you can find them, if their work can be saved, so too might this world. Be quick, for time grows short, and guard against the cross, for there are many who will stand in your way. It is done. The message is delivered. We are gone now from this world. All of us. We can do no more. The rest is up to you, Desmond.
What? Who is Desmond? I don't understand. Please, wait. I have so many questions.
There's only about 10 minutes until
need
I get...
Need all of my equipment.
Ready to go before they do. Desmond!
Yeah.
All right, Sean, I need you and Rebecca to get everything in here packed up and loaded into the truck. You and I'll deal with the Templars.
What, they're here?
It was only a matter of time before they discovered us. To be honest, I'm surprised it took them as long as it did.
Let's go.
Uh-oh, Doc. Looks like it's just you and me now.
Enjoy your victory, Mr. Miles. Temporary as it is.
Desmond! We have to go!
The Templars prepared to enslave us all. They've found us. They've crashed our hideout and we're fleeing the scene looking for a place to hide. Only there isn't any and time is running short.
Lucy, I can't seem to get a position on Ezio's POE.
POE? Could one of you tell me what's going on?
Sorry, Desmond. Peace of Eden. In the Vatican, Minerva talked about other temples, that they're the key to preventing whatever terrible thing is about to happen to the Earth.
Right.
To find the temples, I'm convinced we need to get our hands on Ezio's Apple of Eden. Minerva altered it somehow when she touched it.
Wait, we're at the Auditore Villa.
Yes. It's our last safe house in Italy. It turns out the Templars are watching the border.
Ezio hid the POE sometime in 1507, but when I try to access that DNA sequence, he seems to be remembering something else.
Like a memory inside a memory?
Yes, exactly. Maybe.
Exactly maybe?
I believe you experienced something similar back at Abstergo, didn't you?
Subject 15 exhibited memory within memory-like patterns, but she was pregnant. The memories of both the fetus's father and mother were competing.
Desmond's not pregnant, at least. Well, as far as I can tell. Might just have had a big lunch.
Can you skip ahead to a later memory?
No, it doesn't work.
Well, that sounds familiar. We couldn't access Altair's later memories until Desmond had improved his synchronization.
Then it's possible something similar has occurred here. Ezio's troubled state is being transposed onto Desmond, destabilizing the memory. Either that, or Rebecca's just not a very good engineer.
Thanks, asshole.
What? I'm simply listing possible explanations. And that is amongst the most likely. Touchy.
This place isn't secure. Cell phone surveillance can see right through the walls.
Don't you mean satellite surveillance?
Are you kidding? Abstergo upgraded to cell towers ages ago. The waves go through everything above ground. They're gonna find us.
No, they aren't. Come with me. There's a beam blocking it from the inside. We're not getting in this way.
What's our next move?
The road just loops back into the highway. This is not a good place for us to be right now.
Do we have any tarps? We need to cover up the van.
I really hate to stress this, yeah, but we are running out of time.
Well, help us then, Sean. Do you have any ideas?
I don't know. Maybe there's another way into the sanctuary.
Hey, I think I've got something.
Desmond, that was pretty awesome.
It just felt natural. We can get in through here.
Good job.
We'll just wait up here then, shall we? Yeah, all alone, with massive targets painted on our backs.
Ezio must have come back here way after the attack. But why?
Desmond!
Right. Let's open that door.
You guys did it!
About bloody time. What's that?
Looks like something Ezio left behind. There are numbers underneath it. 1419, 1420, and 1421.
Maybe you should lie down for a bit.
No, it's all right. I'm fine.
Whoa, they really built this place to last. No signs of structural damage, no cell signal either. Should be safe to set up. Let's get the Animus down there.
Okay, everything's good here. Sean, hide the van in town, and make sure you aren't followed.
What? What is that smell?
It's my clothes.
They smell like you swam through a sewer.
It was Lucy's idea.
Wait a second, guys. We need power down here. There's a line running nearby I can hook into, but the wattage is weak.
Oh, yeah, of course. Yeah, yeah. Anything else you two would like? You know, some caviar, perhaps? Maybe you'd like me to knit you a lovely hat. No? Fine, follow me. Right, look around Monte Rigioni for circuit boxes. Rebecca's little doodahs, they'll reroute small amounts of electricity to the power line underneath the villa. Don't ask me how they work. If I understood that, I wouldn't be the fella hiding the van.
Back.
Just in time. The sun's rising.
Yes! It's booted. We're good to go.
Did you miss me? No? Anyone? Hello? Am I speaking out loud? Hello? Workaholics.
Let's get started.
Any news from the outside?
Rebecca's patched in a phone line. The Templars are still guarding the border, and Vidic seems to be busy too.
Doing what?
From the looks of things, he's using Animus data to train Abstergo operatives.
Meaning?
Abstergo's preparing for a full-on assault.
How long do we have before the Templar satellite launch?
It's October 8th, so that leaves us with 74 days.
Not much time.
Think about all that you've been through in the last month. 74 days is a long time. Sometimes I feel so disconnected from everything out there. Nearly a decade of my life gone, searching for those pieces of Eden.
Think how great you'll feel when we finally stop the Templars.
I'm not sure it will ever end, Desmond. I can't do this forever.
I don't buy it. The Lucy I know brought me here and taught me how to see. She would never give up.
I guess I trained you pretty well, huh?
You did all right.
You're all set to go.
Got it. Colosseum.
Let's go. We can be there before dawn.
Wait, there was something about that door. I don't think I saw a handle. Let me run an analysis.
Great. So we need some kind of futuristic key.
It seems to open with a verbally triggered mechanism. I've never seen anything like it.
You mean it needs a password?
Try humming Beethoven's Fifth.
Damn European power grid. Now we can't scan Ezio's memories to find the password.
Hey, maybe it has something to do with this.
The symbol matches the one on the door to the vault.
1419, 1420, 1421. What if they aren't dates?
1419, 1420. Oh my God.
What?
God!
Tell us already!
I am! The Tetragrammaton, the 72 names of God! You see? They're all contained within three verses, Exodus 19 through 21. And get this, you'll like this, if you arrange the four Hebrew letters in God's name within an equilateral triangle, their numerical values add up to the same number. 72!
Are you absolutely sure about this?
That's kind of why I'm saying it out loud, Rebecca, yeah, but I haven't got to the kicker yet. Construction on the Colosseum began in the year 72.
I think we have our password.
Sean, go get the van.
Deja vu.
I bet.
Let's go.
Whoa, what about us, eh? You might actually need a historian down there.
Sean's right. That tunnel should lead under Capitoline Hill. I'll help them find another entrance. Be careful, Desmond.
I'll drive.
Ah, yeah, nice try. I've seen your car.
To this space, the epilogue of our ending. Let it be found by he who is deemed worthy. Let it guide him. Let it shape his path forward. Let it save the world we leave behind.
Who are you?
In the beginning, we set our truths to parchment, to stone, to the memory of men. These proved impermanent things, Cleansed by fire. Cleansed by famine. Cleansed by flood. All the world is innocent once more. Innocent and ignorant.
Coming.
Took you long enough.
What is this place?
Santa Maria Araqueli. See those columns along the aisles? They're lifted from Roman ruins. Now, supposedly, this church was built on top of the ancient temple of Juno.
I like the ceiling.
Do you like the ceiling? Oh, you are a fascinating traveling companion. A dead end.
I'm not so sure.
Kill us, mate. You're gonna have to try a little harder than that.
We're here.
Now for that password. If Sean's right, that is.
I'm always right.
About that dead end.
That never happened. I was misquoted.
Think it speaks English?
Just say it!
Okay. 72.
So where are the temples?
You want me to ask it?
Or think it or something. You sure you asked it the right thing?
I know this, I know that symbol. That's a Phrygian cap. It stands for freedom, and that's a Masonic eye. Now those two come together in only one way.
What's that? I can't move.
Your DNA communes with the apple. You have activated it.
Let me go!
On the 72nd day before the moment of awakening, you, birthed from our loins and the loins of our enemies, the end and the beginning, who we abhor and honor, the final journey commences. There is one who would accompany you through the gate. She lies not within our sight. The cross darkens the horizon.
What are you doing?
The path must be opened. You cannot escape your part in this. The scales shall be balanced.
Stop! Please!
You know very little. We must guide you. Your struggle.
Desmond will lead you to the apple, and then you bring it right to us.
No!
We're counting on you, Lucy. You have served the Templar Order well, and we never forget loyalty.
It is done. The way lies all before you. Only she remains to be found. Awaken the sixth. Go. Alone!
Okay, I shut down the Animus monitoring system to free up a lot of memory, but even like this, it's still risky.
Desmond will be fine. The partition worked, the Animus is stable, and his signs are good.
For now. But this was built to recreate memories, not simulate entire cognitive processes.
The Animus will do its part, and Desmond will do the rest.
What's happening? I can't move. I can't.
No!
They buried her already.
I heard.
In a little cemetery outside Rome. Nice place.
Oh, God, things got so fucked up so fast.
His genes contain high concentrations of first civilization DNA.
Go. Alone.
Hello?
Just walk right past me.
16?
No, they didn't tell you my name.
Oh, God damn it, I'm still in the Animus?
What a shock you suffered out there.
Rebecca! Get me out of here!
They can't help you, Desmond. You're a broken man. Your mind, it's... broken.
Broken? I feel fine.
So did I.
Hey!
Look at me now! Let's talk, buddy. Walk with me.
What is this place?
It's nice, isn't it? We're in the guts of the Animus. The original test program. No memories here, just basic physics, weather simulations. Hello, world. You're lucky someone up there had the sense to plug you in here. Saved your life.
Saved it from what?
Right now, you should be sitting in a hospital ward, drooling and chewing on your tongue. For now, the Animus is keeping you intact. Keeping all your ancestors from collapsing into one big mess. But if you can't find a sync nexus, all those personalities will smash together. That won't be pretty.
A sync nexus?
I'm getting there. Hold on. There. That thing is your way out.
You're screwing with me.
Here's the problem. Your brain is hash. Too many ghosts in your head, too many voices. So how do you fix that? You claw your way back into the stored data, you find unfinished memories, and you crack them open. Finish what you started, until your ancestor has nothing left to show you. That is a sync nexus. And when you find it, the Animus can separate Desmond from Ezio and Altair and send you home, back to your body.
How do you know all this?
Because it happened to me. But my body, it's worm food now. So I'm stuck here. A word of warning? When you step through there, everything changes. Nothing feels normal. But you are still in control, and it's up to you to find your way out.
Right.
If you hurry, you might make it back in time for Lucy's funeral.
What?
Oh. I thought you knew.
Lucy. Oh, God. I'm so sorry. Wasn't me. Wasn't me. It was that voice. Juno. She took hold of me. She made me.
Do you regret anything, Desmond? What's it like spending your whole life avoiding hard decisions?
Come on.
Sure, you're an assassin, but it wasn't your choice.
Do you have a point?
I want to know if you regret anything.
Sure. I wish I'd been more patient with my parents. I wish I'd listened. And Lucy, maybe things could have been different if I'd... I'm not sure.
Thank you.
For what?
For making sense.
No books. No wisdom. Just you fratello mio. Requiescat in pace, Altair. Seen to my books?
Yes. Some we sent with the Polos. The rest will go with me to Alexandria.
Good. Very good.
Father, I do not understand. Why did you build a library if you did not intend to keep your books?
You should go. When the Mongols return, Masyaf must be empty.
I see. This is not a library at all. It is a vault.
It must stay hidden, Darim. Far from eager hands. At least until it has passed on the secret it contains.
What secret?
Go, son. Go be with your family. And live well.
All that is good in me began with you, Father.
Away. Tell them I sent it to Cyprus, or Sipango, or that I dropped it into the sea. Tell them anything to keep men away from this place. This apple must not be found. Not until the time is right.
Here it comes!
What is that? What's going on?
This is the end, Desmond. Scheduled for deletion!
What are you doing?
What is a man but the sum of his memories? We are the stories we live, the tales we tell ourselves!
Don't do this!
I'm saving you, idiot! Go! Go!
Another artifact. No. You will stay here. I have seen enough for one life. Desmond?
He's talking to me?
I heard your name once before, Desmond. A long time ago. And now it lingers in my mind. Like an image from an old dream. I do not know where you are, or by what means you can hear me. But I know you are listening. I have lived my life as best I could. Not knowing its purpose, but drawn forward like a moth to a distant moon. And here at last, I discover a strange truth. That I am only a conduit for a message that eludes
is my understanding. Who are we who have been so blessed to share our stories like this? To speak across centuries? Maybe you will answer all the questions I have asked. Maybe you will be the one to make all this suffering worth something in the end. Now, listen.
Do you hear me, Cypher? Can you see me? Ah, there you are. Good. A strange place, this Nexus of Time. I am not used to the calculations. That has always been Minerva's domain. I see you still have many questions. Who were we? What became of us? What do we desire of you? You will have your answers. Only listen, and I will tell you how. Both before the end and after, we sought to save the world. We built vaults within which to work, each dedicated to a different method of salvation. They were placed underground to avoid the war which raged above, and also as a precaution should we fail in our efforts. Each vault's knowledge was transmitted to a single place. It was our duty, mine, Minerva's, and Juno's, to sort and sample all that was collected. We chose those solutions which held the most promise and devoted ourselves to testing their merits. Six we tried in succession, each more encouraging than the last, but none worked. And then the world ended. Earth shook for days, the fires burned for weeks, and when the ash had settled, less than 10,000 of your kind still lived, and far fewer of ours. But we carried on, together, to rebuild, to renew. Listen, you must go there, to the place where we labored and lost. Take my words. Pass them from your head into your hands. That is how you will open the way. But be warned, much still remains in flux, and I do not know how things will end, either in my time or yours.
Wait, look, his vitals are stabilizing. Something's happening. He's moving.
Desmond, can you hear me? Son?
I know what we need to do.
In another moment, down went Alice after it, never once considering how in the world she was to get out again.
You must find the key.
Son?
Sir?
Here we go again.
I believe it is time we welcome Charles into our fold. He has proven himself a loyal disciple and served unerringly since the day he came to us. He should be able to share in our knowledge and reap all the benefits that such a gift implies. Are any opposed? Very well. Charles, come, stand. Do you swear to uphold the principles of our order and all that for which we stand?
I do.
And never to share our secrets nor divulge the true nature of our work?
I do.
And to do so from now until death, whatever the cost.
I do.
Then we welcome you into our fold, brother. Together, we will usher in the dawn of a new world, one defined by purpose and order. Give me your hand. You are a Templar.
May the Father of Understanding guide us.
May the Father of Understanding guide us.
Wait, what? You all saw that, right?
Wow.
Wow indeed.
The key must be the amulet Haytham took from London.
We might know what it looks like, but we're no closer to finding it. Desmond, you need to keep going.
Hey, he's your ancestor too. Why don't you hop in the Animus?
Really? That's your response? It's like dealing with a six-year-old. What is wrong with you, Desmond?
You want to know what's wrong? I'm sick of being treated like I'm not even here. Desmond, do this. Desmond, do that. Desmond, you better figure things out because the sun is going to turn us all to ash. And I know I was really nice to you, but actually I'm just another Templar plot twist. And yes, I would like very much for you to be controlled by a magic space wizard so that you can murder me. So there's your answer. I'm sick of being a goddamn pawn. I thought it might be different with you. I mean, you're my father, but it turns out you're no better than the fucking Templars.
Don't you ever equate me to those bastards again. You hear me? Everything I do, everything I have done, has been for you. Maybe I pushed a little too hard, asked a little too much, but try and remember exactly what's at stake here. You need to get it together, kid. Running out of time.
Right, that was unusual. Well, I'm just going to pretend that this never happened and get back to bringing everyone up to speed on where we stand. The news isn't good. It appears this temple is powered by a collection of, well, I guess they're batteries. You found one on your way in, but there aren't any more, at least not down here.
Any idea on where we can find replacements?
Not yet, so I intend to tiptoe into the Abstergo database. Now, if I can cross-reference these particular devices with their database, then maybe we'll get lucky.
See what you can do.
Obviously. Anyway, Desmond, you can either take a look around here or we can head back to the Animus.
All right, here goes.
Once upon a time, we had a ceremony on such occasions. But I don't think either of us are really the type for that. You've your tools and training, your targets and goals. And now you have your title. Welcome to the Brotherhood, Connor.
Welcome back, Desmond. You'll be happy to hear there's actually good news for once.
Yeah?
I've managed to locate a power source, and it's relatively close by. Up for a trip to Manhattan?
Is it safe to leave? Abstergo's gotta be looking for us.
Obviously it's not safe. Can't exactly sit around here hoping to get lucky, though, can we? We need that power source. Besides, I'm sure you can cook up some way to hide our movements.
Maybe. The Templars have access to all kinds of satellites and camera systems. We'll need to find a way to mask our digital signature. I can probably camouflage the van, too. But there's not much I can do for us.
That's an easy one.
Desmond. Not exactly what I expected, but I guess your kind doesn't have many options these days.
Who are you?
Ask your father. Now give me that.
I don't think so.
Look, I'm not supposed to kill you, but the boss man didn't say anything about fucking you up. So you got to the counter. Oh!
So who the hell is Daniel Cross?
Believe it or not, he used to be an assassin. The assassin, the way I've heard it told, but it turned out he was a sleeper agent for Abstergo, programmed to infiltrate and destroy the organization.
How did he know you were there? We could be compromised.
They must have caught me snooping inside their network and sent Cross to see what we were after. If they were aware of our current location, we'd know. Though, I will say this, it doesn't bode very well for future expeditions.
I've set up some cameras topside. If anyone shows up, we'll see it.
I'd suggest you go see about finding a socket for that power source. Or we can return to Connor if you prefer. All the artifacts in the world won't mean a thing without the key.
Wonder what's inside.
Only one way to find out.
We could be saved. We sought to face the sun's wrath and contain it. Four towers would be built to pull her fury into this place and dispel it. But even with all we knew, with all we had, it would take too long. 1,000 years we could labor and still the work would not be done. The first tower was never completed. The project abandoned. We moved on. But while we labored on other endeavors, a few returned. They thought to automate the process. Metal might finish what flesh could not. If we could not meet the sun's cruel embrace, perhaps we might rebuke it. Already we could generate the fields to protect us in times of strife. But these were small and simple things. To replicate them on a scale the size of a world. We lack the energy to make it so. Half the world, they said then. It is better than none at all. We tried. Again, we failed. A quarter, they asked. Even this we could not do. A sixth, an eighth, a tenth, they cried. The answer was still the same. Perhaps in time a city might be spared. But it was time we did not have. So we moved on.
I'm telling you, there's something down here.
Don't be daft.
I don't know. Maybe they were sleeping or something and we woke them. Some kind of cryogenics? Or hibernation? I mean, how do we know what the hell they were doing down here?
They were working on a bunch of different solutions, but nothing worked. Just went from one to the next, and then... I don't know. They must have left at some point. After the end.
I wonder what the world would be like if they'd succeeded.
I'm more concerned about what it'll be like if we don't.
Salvation. They found a way. Too late for them, but not for you. Sealed to protect it. Though now it bars your way. Find the key. The past will tell.
Sean has located a second power source. I've asked Rebecca to charter a flight for us.
Where to?
Brazil.
What's the plan?
According to our intel, the power source is being worn as a bracelet by some tycoon's trophy wife. We're working on pinpointing her location, but she's most likely inside a VIP booth on the stadium's upper level. I'll update you when I know more.
Gotta find a ticket.
We don't have time to play nice. Steal someone else's.
Bit of a dick move, don't you think?
Well, I guess you could try and sneak past security instead.
We can get back to Connor whenever you're ready, Desmond. Unless you want to plug in the power source first. Up to you.
Awaiting discovery? Or might it be changed? Here we learned the answer, and thought that it might save us. They were used to command, to control, to own. But we soon discovered another use. When enough sat enthralled and were told to believe, their thoughts took on form. What is imagined became real. If 100 minds could wish away a wall or create a tree, what might 1,000 do? 10,000? More? Might we change the consensus and will the threat away? We resolved to send one into the sky where it might illuminate us all. Once placed, a sentence would be uttered. Make us safe. In this way, we would change the consensus. We would save the world. But it never came to be. We sent a dozen of them skyward, but there was no way to maintain control, to direct the beam. To enthrall the world. To speak the words. Though this was strange and dangerous, what we tried next was worse. Our first instinct was to travel back, to change the past. But we could not find a way. But forward, we could look forward. And so here we sought to see beyond ourselves and know what was to come. First we watched to learn if our work would succeed. But the answer was always the same. So we moved on to other things. But she remained. The one you call Minerva. In time, she too stopped looking, and instead began to speak. She called out across time, in the hopes that you might be saved. She hid messages where none might find them, save for you and those within this place.
Fascinating.
Tired of it. The cryptic warnings, the threats. Just tell us what you want!
But they are. We saw the Nephilim there. We seemed like grasshoppers in our own eyes, and we looked the same to them. Imagine trying to explain all this to a 2-year-old, to a grasshopper. When they said the will of the gods was unknowable, they meant it. Literally.
I killed her, you know. I killed Lucy.
It was the apple, son. It was Juno.
I saw what she was. What would happen if I let her live? I could have stopped myself. I mean, there was a force there. But I didn't have to. I chose to.
Desmond.
Lucy was going to betray us and take the apple back to Abstergo. I saw the satellite launched. I saw them turn it on, and then it failed. Whatever's on the other side of that door, it benefits Juno. We need to be careful.
Look at that. I found a third power source.
Already?
It popped up in an earlier search, but I've only just managed to confirm it.
Where?
There's a museum in Cairo with one on display.
I guess Connor will have to wait.
No, you stay. We need to find that key, and time is running out. I'll make the trip.
What about Cross?
Everything's going to be fine. I'll be back soon.
Ready when you are, Desmond. Something's happened, Desmond. Abstergo has your dad.
Where?
Italy. Same place they were holding you.
What are you two waiting for? Let's go.
There's more.
Hello again, Mr. Miles. I hope this message finds you well, or as well as it can, all things considered. It appears we now each have something the other desires. I propose a trade. Bring me the apple, and I'll return your father to you no worse for the wear. Should you refuse, he will still be returned, albeit much worse for the wear. I assume you'd like to avoid an unpleasant outcome.
They're probably holding your father on the upper levels, same place they kept you. There's an elevator bank down the hall. Try not to let them see you.
They know I'm here, Rebecca. There's no way they don't.
This was a bad idea.
Hand over your weapons and come with me, sir.
I can show myself in, but thanks for the offer.
I'd rather this not turn ugly, Mr. Miles.
Then let me through.
Subdue the subject, please.
Fourth floor.
Where's my father?
You'll see him soon enough. Now be a good boy and wait for security to fetch you.
You're gonna have to climb the rest of the way.
Give me the apple. Let's not draw this out. You got nowhere to go, and I've got a gun. Speaking of which, it's the 21st century and you're still running around with only a tiny knife for protection? It's stupid. All right, Desmond. Game's over. Not now. Not now! Я исчезну, работа! Нет! Get out!
What the hell was that? Where's Vidic?
Fifth floor.
So fast, Mr. Miles. In case you hadn't noticed, I'm the one calling the shots. Now give me the apple.
You want it? Fine. Here it is.
Wait! No!
Never should have come here. You put everything on the line. For what? So you could rescue your father?
Yeah.
I'd get the power source hooked up before heading back into the Animus. But it's your call.
Dark and cold. It would consume us. For we were flesh, and flesh is frail. Though suits and shields might offer comfort, such adornments would not suffice. Not to save us all. So we sought to change what we were. In this manner, we might thrive in a world made poisonous. It was Aita who volunteered to see if it might be done. Aita, my husband, my love. In the end, it changed him, ruined him. He was made a prisoner of the machines. The body might survive, but his mind became brittle to the touch. He begged me for release, for days, for weeks, for months. I pleaded with him to give us time to find another way. But there wasn't one. Not for him. Not for us. What is consciousness but a series of electrical impulses? And the body, a vessel to hold these sparks. But it is weak. In time, it decays and crumbles into dust. We asked ourselves then, what if it might be replaced with something stronger, something better? So we forged a new vessel. One that might endure. It proved easy enough to enter. But to leave required something more, something wrong. And so this too they abandoned. I wondered, though, were they right to turn away?
Home stretch, Desmond. I can feel it.
Why would they leave this behind?
Long have we waited for you to return. You have done as we asked. You have succeeded.
No, I have failed. My people are gone. Chased out by those who I thought would protect them.
It is a trade, a sacrifice, and not in vain. For you have found it.
This?
Now you must hide it. Where none shall think to look. And then in time, what once was shall be again.
I do not understand.
Nor need you. Only do as we ask. Then you may do as you wish.
But what of my people?
You have saved this place. As was your people's purpose, and that matters most.
It is not enough.
It will never be enough. You strive for that which does not exist. Still, you have made a difference, and And you will do so again. Remember, you must hide the amulet where none might find it.
Let's go.
So, this will be a short one, Dad. Something to remember me by if things go south. If I don't make it out of the temple today. I can only believe that what we are doing is the right thing. And that I can stop this disaster. I know this. I mean, the technology is there, waiting for us to use it. I'm the final piece of the puzzle. Something in my genes, or my memories. Some final piece of code to switch the whole thing on. That's why I'm here.
Moment of truth.
That's why they brought me here. Only, I don't know what I'll have to give up in return. My sanity. My life. It's impossible to say. I do know this. Our battle with the Templars will not be over. Whatever's inside that temple is not an ending. It's just another chapter in this endless story. And it'll be your job. And Mom's. And Sean's. And Rebecca's. To keep turning the pages.
Yes. Come. Here, at last. You know our story now. Of how we tried. Of how we failed. All our hopes extinguished. Save one. Your touch. A spark. A spark to save the world.
Wait! Do not touch the pedestal.
Minerva?
You! But how? You left! You destroyed the device!
Did you think there was only one?
What the hell is going on here?
You must not free her.
Free her?
Juno dwells within these walls, awaiting release. I will explain. While we worked to save the world, she sought instead to conquer it. She used our machines to set her plans in motion. Divination through numbers. There is a pattern to existence. To comprehend the calculations is to tame time. This was my focus. And so I built the eye to aid us. But she turned it towards her own ends. When we discovered her treachery, we put a stop to it. And then we left. But first we called to you, that you might try again. We thought it would be safe with her gone. Now I see we were deceived. She survived, she endured, and then she began to work. For centuries, Tinia and I walked the world, hoping to rekindle the spark of civilization. We shared what we knew as best we could. We were not the only ones, but for all the power we wrought, still death would claim us. But before it did, I would have one last look to know if we had succeeded.
That's how you're here now?
I had hoped you might find this place. And finish our work. But it is too late. You and the Templars have squabbled over our refuse. You have wasted centuries, and so you have lost your chance. You cannot hope to stop the end now, Desmond. Only to survive.
She's lying! Only touch the pedestal and the world will be saved.
Better the world burn than she be loosed upon it.
Is that so? Show him then.
But he will not understand. It is complicated. It is...
Show me.
If you heed Minerva, the sun will have its way. The ground will crack and spit fire into the skies. All the world will burn. But this does not end the world, merely heralds its arrival. Darkness follows. Then you emerge, resolving to lay a foundation that such a tragedy does not befall the world again. You will become a symbol to those who survive. Hope, knowledge, determination. You will inspire them to rebuild, to thrive once more. And as the world heals, so too will humanity. But you are just a man, frail and mortal. You pass from the world, leaving behind only a memory. A legacy. You will be remembered first as a hero, later as a legend, and in time, as a god. It is the cruelest fate to have written words that meant well and see them made wicked and unwise. What was meant to encourage life, used instead to justify taking it. And so now you see that what was shall be again. So tell me, how is this better? She would sacrifice you, sacrifice the world, for no other reason than to deny me vindication.
They will enslave your kind, Desmond. Is this not why you fight? Is this not why you came here? To ensure more than just your race's future, but its freedom?
What future? What freedom? Billions dead and the whole cycle begun anew? This world has known nothing but heartache and horror since we left it.
Our gift to them, and you'd see it all returned.
Enough!
You must not do this.
Whatever Juno's planning, however terrible it might seem today, we'll find a way to stop it. But the alternative, what you want, there's no hope there.
If you free her, you'll be destroyed.
It will happen in an instant. There will be no pain.
You mustn't!
It's done, Minerva. The decision's made.
Then the consequences of this mistake are yours to live and die with.
You need to go. All of you. Now. Get as far away from here as you can.
Come with us! We'll find another way.
There isn't time.
Son.
You know it's true. It's already started. I need to do this now. So go. Go!
You know, I keep thinking about something Orson Welles once said. Something like, if you want a happy ending, it all depends on where you stop telling your story. So maybe that's the answer. Maybe that's how people keep marching forward. If something goes wrong and they're dead, something happens to me. When you tell my story years from now, please tell them the one about how I lost my way, and then I found it again, just in time to save the world, and just end it there. That'll keep everyone smiling. Goodbye, Dad. Say hello to Mom. Tell her I love her, okay? Tell her I love you both. I love you both.
My name is Desmond Miles, and I am an assassin. I am an assassin.